Hey everybody, today I got another sequential combo log for you. In the last video, a few people were a bit disappointed that I didn't try to make a better combo log, so that just that I challenged myself to make a combo log without using certain components. So that's why I went back to the creative world and created this design over here, which I think turned out quite good. This sequential combo log has a 15 button panel, which makes it extremely secure. In the version I built up here, only one in 11,390,625 combination would activate the output line, which you could use, for example, to open a door. The design is also, I would say, quite compact. So if you look on the side here, there's no blocks. There also are no blocks. I just added the door here on the side. On top, there are no blocks. And also the ground level is also the, yeah, all the space we need for the combo lock. The design is also rather simple to understand and also rather simple to build. And it's also infinitely expandable. So here we have a 6-digit combination that would activate the output line. But you can also even get even a more secure combo lock to get billions of combinations. Or you can also shorten it. If you would only have 3 segments, then you already have 3,325 combinations. So this is a, I think a really good design. Alright, it's time for a showcase. So for this door we need a 6-digit combination to activate the output line. The code for this one here is lime, blue. You always have to wait a little bit and not spam the button, so wait until the button has turned off before you press the next one. Then magenta, brown, yellow, and the last one, cyan. It's hooked up to a rocket dispenser, and the door would also open. Alright, if we press a different button now, then we don't have the correct combination anymore. Door closes and so on. So only the right combination would activate the output line. Before I'll show you how you can build this, I want to explain how this thing works. It actually works quite similar to the combo log from the last video, but instead of storing information in binary, we're using the hexadecimal, using comparators, of course. Alright, let's start with the button input panel. So we got 15 different buttons. You could even expand it to 16. You could add another button here. I think just 15 looks nicer. And we would activate pistons. And all of those pistons would in the end trigger this line of redstone here. And depending on which piston we would activate, we get a certain signal strength output at this blue block here. So we could follow this. We would activate the white button, then this redstone block extends. Here we have signal strength 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10. Here you can also see a little cheat sheet. Depending on which button you press, you get this signal strength at the light blue concrete block. We can actually try it out. So let's maybe press magenta to get 13. I also added information here already in the back. You can see 13 redstone lamps turn on. And we store the first information. We got signal strength 13 here. So if I press another button, let's for example try 1. This is the blue one. Then we get 1 and the 13 shifted 1 over. If you were to press silver block, then we got 7, the one that's there next, and the 13 also shifted one over. Alright, and this works with every value. 0 is also a possibility. So if you press the brown block, then we store 0. 15 is the yellow one. And the only single strength is missing right now would be 9. Also, we're still missing a color. If we would add a black one here on the side, black concrete, this would be easily possible. Just looks a bit odd. We just need to add, sticky piston, redstone block, and another single redstone dust here. And then we would get the output for single strength 9 here. Also, you might have noticed I'm making good use of the composter. That was a new addition to the Minecraft 1.14 snapshots. Since this is finally a movable block, we can store more single strengths than just with the cauldron. So they have certain fill levels. So this one has a fill level of 8, and this one has a fill level of 3. Which, yeah, with the cauldron, you only had 4 levels, 0, 1, 2, 3. And with the composter, we can also store additionally 4, 5, 6, and 8. 7 is not a possibility, because if you it basically converts the fill level 7 into 8 in 1 second. So you can't really hold the single strength of 7, but we don't need it. For example, here we extend this composter, which is 8. Then here we have 8 at this dust line. If you go one over, it's 7, of course. Oh yeah, by the way, for the signal strength 0, we just activate this sticky piston, but we don't have any signal strength output here, which basically activates the shift register. Alright, so next I want to explain you how we basically store the signal strength, and also how we shift one over. So we use, of course, two comparators to hold the signal strength. So if we give an input here, it stores the signal strength 12. Powering the block, redstone dust directly in the back. We give in the same signal strength into the next comparator and yeah, basically keep this in a circle. If you want to delete the value, we just have to overwrite one of those comparators. And if you want to shift one over, we can check that out here. That's basically the module I use 6 times. So let's put in value first. So here we got 12 now. So we want what we want to do is put the signal strength of 12 into the next storage. Of course, we also need to delete that value here, the 12, so we can put in the next one. So we override the comparator by powering it from the repeater from the side. And here we have this line of comparators, which I need in order to temporarily hold the single strength of 12. Because it just yeah, puts it into the next single strength storage cell. So we also temporarily unlock this comparator here, so yeah, we can send information one block over, and that's pretty much it. So I just need a certain input. Yeah, this line at the top is basically the reset line and responsible shift one over. We got a 6 game tick input, which would activate this repeater, unpause this one here, and let's just check it out. So now we got the signal strength 12 here. So if we would put in a different value here now, we got 14 and activate this. Now we got 14 stored here. Alright, now we just need to basically check if we have the correct signal strength in each segment, and if yes, give out an output. Alright, so in order to do that, we can take out an output here and reduce the signal strength of the basically where we store the information, which is the correct code. Alright, I build it up over here again. In this case, we get a signal strength of 13. Okay, let's say we want 13 to be the correct value. Then we reduce the signal strength of this comparator by 13. In the back, we get a cake, so now it's 1. So basically, I always check if the output here is 1. Alright, this basically means the comparator is on, which turns this torch off. And now to check if we actually have signal strength 1, I'm gonna run another redstone dust line here, which powers a repeater. And also as an input into this OR gate. So that means only if you have signal strength 1 as an output of this comparator, this dust line here on top is turned off. Alright, if we would have an even higher value, so let's say we have 15 here, then of course this comparator turns completely off, the torch turns on, and the line is on. Alright, let's put in a lower signal strength. So here we got now 11. The torch is still turned off, but here we have signal strength 3, so this also enables the repeater, and now this line is also on. So only if you have 13 exactly, this line is completely off. So in the case of the complete combo lock build, we have 6 of those segments chained together. So here this would be the OR gate, and you basically chain 6 of those OR gates together to an even larger OR gate, and if all of those lines are turned off, then you would activate the output line, which in case, yeah, this one here, would activate the dispenser. Okay, just need to press one more combination. And there you go. We activate here. Also here I put in a Fortic repeater because sometimes there's a bit of flickering within the line. So this basically prevents incorrect activation. So you might have noticed this in case we want to check for signal strength 15 or 0, we have to do a slightly different system, but I'll explain it in the tutorial. Alright, let's do a tutorial. So I need to bring the following materials that I got in my hotbar and inventory. That's by the way, is a note block, not a jukebox, important. Only note block will work, iron trapdoor. Also bring some materials to fill in the composters. Good material is pumpkin pie, because then there's no randomness. Alright, so let's start. So let's start with the button panel. I actually recommend to color code it, because it's probably even easier to remember colors than it is to remember numbers. Alright, so we just got 15 different concrete colors, but you could use also different materials, of course. Alright, let's go to the back. Here we need some repeaters at the bottom. Then above, note blocks. Then now we need the observers here. Then repeaters again. Hold shift to place those. And trapdoors again. And another set of observers. And each of those outputs would point into a sticky piston. So now we're gonna add the composters, redstone blocks, and a block here in front. Put in the composters and top redstone blocks. And now we need to fill those composters. So I would recommend to check with the F3 menu here. The levels on the bottom left, we need 3, the next one as well. Then we need 1 and 4. And this row needs to be filled completely, so up to level 7 to jump to 8. Alright, we got all 8s here. Perfect. And now we need to add comparators and repeaters to read the output of the composters and other blocks. So here we place a line of blocks, and here we put a repeater on top, and just a redstone torch here. The rest we need comparators. Then we actually need a second line here, another repeater there, and comparators. Then blocks in between, which we place comparators on. Then blocks in front, also blocks here. On top we need repeaters, and here redstone dust. Alright. Then another redstone dust line here, and front repeaters, blocks. Okay, so next we're gonna take the output from this block here, adding another comparator there. Here in the middle we add a sticky piston, turn observer facing to the side, then you wanna get a slab, put it right here, and put a 3-tick repeater on top. Points into a block, and we have a torch in front. So now here at the bottom, this comparator points into a block. And you have the first holding cell, but this is actually not used later, it's just temporary. And here we're gonna add 3 comparators already. And now we can start with the storage cells for the information. Okay, I'm just gonna use another color again. I think this made sense to show it. So this is 1. Then normal blocks in between, the second one. I think I'm gonna make a version of 3 segments. Should be enough for most cases, because this will already give 3,325 possible combinations. It's plenty. Alright, then place comparators like this. They all point to blocks, of course. Dust next to it. And then you can add the 3 comparators here in between. Then we can add the repeaters on the side. Yeah, here we need them as well. So always pointing to this one and this one. And they also have to be on subtract mode. And another one here. Okay, then the back of each repeater, we want a block. Put some redstone dust top of those. Okay, and then we can continue with the reset line or the shift set one over. So always right next to this dot, we put a torch. And on top of that dot, a block. Then in between, you can also place blocks. And repeater pointing to all of those blocks. Also here at the back, another torch. And then just put dust on top of each of the remaining blocks. Okay, the whole line is powered. Still need to put in torches here. And yeah, this is finished. So next we want to program the machine, and it's not super complicated, we just need to put in containers with a certain fill level. Alright, what we can already do, to each of those sides we need to put down a comparator on subtract mode. So like this, and now on the back, depending on the output you want, you need a container filled to a certain level. Alright, let's just do an example. So let's say we want pink selected. This would be the last button input because it's closest. All right, then we need to go over here to this table. We wrote down the corresponding single strength outputs we have. So middle row, second from the left is 5. So we get a single strength output of 5. So that means we need a container in the back of this hopper, or comparator. I'm using hoppers here. You can also use other containers, except droppers, of course, because they would lose items over time. So you can also use chests, I guess, furnaces, brewing stand, maybe, tracker boxes. Doesn't need to be a hopper. Alright, then we basically want an output of 1. Here we got 5, just the desired output. Single strength stored here, but here we want 1. That means here in the hopper we need to fill it up. So the comparator gives out a single strength of 6. I also made you a little table here. This shows what you need to put in into hoppers, important, in order to get the following single strength. So for 6, we need 1 stack and 51. Okay, 1 stack and 51. We can also check by placing down a redstone dust. Yes, power 6. This is the correct value. And then we need to put a torch on top. You go over to the side, put down 2 redstone dust, repeater. Then we have this redstone dust line here. Alright, I would say we do another example, and then I'll show you what you need to do in case you want single strength 0 and 15 selected. So 15 is the top right one, and 0 is the bottom middle one, brown. Alright, let's do a normal example first. Let's actually do orange next. So we've got an output of signal strength 12. That's why we need in the container we need the fill level for 13. That is basically the second last button input, this one here. Okay, 13. Let's go over to the signs again. 4 stacks and 19. Can also check to be sure. Yes, this is 13. Then again, torch on top. Repeater. And dust. Then block here. And there. And in between, another repeater. Alright, so next word is if we want the yellow one to be selected. So signal string 15. Then we just put a full power source at the back of the comparator, point into a block, Then you have the redstone dust output. Repeater here. And basically do the same. Here we go up. And over. So the logic is basically if you have 15, then only if you have 15, then this comparator turns off. And this means the line here also turns off. Alright, now signal strength 0. Then we need a container here at the back. We put in a single item, so we only get the single strength output of 1. We can remove that. And then we only need the torch here. So the logic is, if we don't have any input here, then this would be on, which turns the torch off. Any other signal strength, so if you have 1 to 15, turns off the comparator, torch will be turned on. Alright, yeah, and this is how you can encode the system. Alright, then we just need the output for everything. So we're gonna add a 4-tick repeater here, and a torch. And this is what be the output line. You can hook this up to your door or whatever you want to activate. Alright, so now let's try it out. So in this example here we had signal strength 0 in the back. This was 12, so the orange one. And then was that one again? I think 5 for the pink. Yeah, so the combination now would be the signal strength 0 first, so brown. Orange and pink. And now this line turns on. Of course, every possible combination is possible to be programmed as a code. You can also have, for example, 3 times yellow in a row. Alright, then the system is also, of course, expandable. Just here need to add more of those segments, which are 5 wide. So from here to here, I guess. Yep, 5 wide. In this case, we have 3 segments for 3,325 possible combinations. If you would have 8 segments, then you already have above 2.5 billion possible combinations. This is quite a lot. And as I mentioned, you can make it even safer by adding the 16th input, which I just think looks a bit odd. But yeah, this would be the signal strength 9, as I mentioned here on the side. All right. Yeah, then we're at the end of the tutorial. I will also provide a world download so you can look it up. That's it. Thanks a lot for watching. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.